Hey guys, Jeff Gelman, Solid Canine Training. A lot of times people always ask me, how young can you start a puppy on, or a dog on a remote collar? This is a 14-week-old dog. It's his first time in here ever. This is actually Brian, believe it or not. He's a super fan on Periscope. This is his first time here. He's been waiting for this day forever. This is his first lesson, 14-week-old puppy. What we're doing is we're using the remote collar as just a marker. It sits in the background. What Brian is going to do is he's going to say name of dog. So the name of dog is, it's going to be Kai, come, and then sit, and then break. Kai, yep, Brian Costa, you got it. Everyone's saying hello to you. Everybody knows you. Everybody knows you. It's like, so this, watch what he does. So I'll explain it as we do it, but this dog's been working for about 15 minutes, and he's probably pooping out. So let's just cut off this, okay? So go ahead.
Kai, come. Good. Sit. Good.
Eye focus.
Good, good. Break.
Good.
Kai, come. Sit. Sit.
Walking.
Sit.
There we go. Good.
Good. Good, good.
Who is he? He's a client. He's just a client that came in. This is his first session.
Great.
He signed up for a 5-session package. 14-week-old puppy. We can actually start puppies on remote collars because all we're using is their food drive. The remote collar sits in the background. So.
Sit. Good.
So this is just.
Good. Okay, Frank.
Yep. Yep, he's always on the chats on here. Now he looks like a trainer because he's got good skills. The dog's working level is a 1.
That's it.
And that itching is his skin. He was itching it before. So he's already crashing out, you can tell.
Sit.
Yeah, it's being used, but it's being used on a level 1, meaning the dog barely feels it. The collar is not doing the training. Look at this eye contact now. Look at this eye contact.
Good.
Look at this eye contact.
Good.
Crashing meaning puppies can only work for so long. So it's 6 o'clock. He's been here since 5.
Five.
So he's doing recall, and then he's already getting distracted.
Sit.
Yep. So he's already not sitting as well as he did 10 minutes ago. He's getting distracted by things behind us.
Sit.
So walk into him a little bit. Yep. And do it again, yep.
Can I come?
Yep, so he's getting distracted, yep. So we're crashing out here.
Sit.
Yep. So walk over here, there's less distractions.
Can I come?
Good, all right. Here we go, and.
Can I sit? Sit.
You can use the food as a lure right now. Use the food as a lure, good. That I count on. So Brian, you can on the sit, as long as you hit that button, you can use your food as your lure.
Okay.
Okay?
Can I come? Good.
Yep, it'll be ended on a great note. Don't worry.
Sit.
There you go. Beautiful.
Good.
Eye contact, focus,
good.
Eye contact, focus.
Good.
Focus, focus. Look at that.
Great.
Awesome. Awesome. 14-week-old puppy. This is his first training session ever, and we introduced him to the remote collar right away. If you like what you see, you can share this on Twitter, share this on Facebook. You can also, that's by hitting the little character in the corner right there. You can also give us mad hearts. This is Brian Costa. No leash, nope, doesn't need a leash. We're using the dog's hunger drive. The dog has not eaten since breakfast. The dog is hungry. The dog is gonna go over to the dog. You don't need a prong. This is not prong work. This is remote collar work. Dog does not need a prong when it doesn't have a leash on. So now he's getting a little bit not as obedient, which means he's crashing. Let's put him on place. We're going to end it on place. Why a remote collar? Because remote collars are the best way to train dogs for off-leash control and high
place.
Levels of distraction outside in the real world.
Sit.
So that was just place.
Good. Good. Good.
Okay. Good. So eye focus, he just taught him place.
Good.
So we can look at eye contact. Okay.
Good.
The remote collar is not activated right now. This is all just eye contact and focus work. That's all this is. 14-week-old puppy, first time in my training center. This kid dog came in dragging around. He learned that in one lesson. He's learning this in about 10 minutes. How does it work? This is not vibration. If we vibrated this collar right now, it would freak the dog out. This is on level 1. It goes up to 100.
Right here. That's it. Good.
So he's food drive.
Good.
Focus. Good. Beautiful. Perfect, Brian.
Good.
Perfect.
Good. Good.
Beautiful, Brian. Excellent
Good.
Job.
Hey,
excellent job. Look at that focus we're getting. This dog came in here out of control. Why is this working? Because it's trained. So no shock. Remote collars don't shock.
That's it.
Dogs are never shocked with a remote collar. That's old, old, old school technology. It's a stim. It's a very light stim. It is just like a TENS unit, a transepidural neurological stimulator. We use stim. This technology, there's no shock. A lot of people use the word shock to scare owners into not using them. Also, they like to use that word because they like to think that it's shocking the dog. Shocking the dog is sticking your finger in a outlet. That is a shock. So I can put this remote collar on my neck at 100 and I can still talk to you. You missed the whole training? Well, no you didn't. You came in right at the beginning. So wait, he's distracted. Good.
That's it. Good.
Look at that focus. Look at that focus. 14-week-old puppy.
Good.
No, there's no leash at all. We're using the dog's food drive.
Good.
We're using food drive. This dog is hungry. When the dog is, the way we introduce remote collars, I've been talking about this for a long time. Food drive with remote collar. Food drive with remote collar.
That's it.
Beautiful.
Good.
Beautiful.
Good.
If you like what you see, heart me up, heart me up, heart me up. Share this on Facebook, share this on Twitter.
Good.
No, the dog doesn't need a leash right now. Not for inside work.
Good.
Just go to the beginning of this, Yoda.
Good.
You came in at the beginning. I've only been doing this, I've only been showing this on Periscope for about 10 minutes tops. All right? So that's, we're gonna end that session. Let's end it on place. Let's put him on place.
Right here.
Watch this, watch this. And
place.
Gave him the place command.
Sit.
Look at that, place, sit, eye contact. Place, sit, eye contact. First session. Why? Because it's actual training.
Good.
This is training. Yep.
Good.
Yep. Yep.
Good.
Okay. And he's tight. All right, we're going to end it right there, but I'm going to still talk to you. I'll answer any questions. Okay. Brian, big shout out. you love this, right?
Oh, man, this is great.
Yeah.
I mean, literally, I wish you would have started earlier because he was doing a lot better, you know, before. Now he's getting a little tired out, but
yeah.
Amazing what can be done in 1 hour.
Yep, awesome. Well, out of respect for the client, for being at the first time here, I didn't want to periscope the whole session because I wanted to not be, I mean, they're paying me for my services. We only did this like the last 10 minutes just to show what it was. He is not a trainer, he is a dog owner. But a lot of my clients could do a better job than a lot of trainers do. All right, so let's just saddle him back up and I'll talk to everybody on this, all right? Let me say my goodbyes. All right, see you later, take care. And take all your equipment with you. Awesome, great job guys, very impressed.
Thank you
so much. So everyone say nice work. The guy's name is Brian. Yep. So break means we're done. You can put that slippery right back on him. Yep. Yep. Awesome. Great job, Brian. So that's it. That's how we start. So we talk about this all the time. How young can you start a dog on a remote collar? 14 weeks using food drive. So what I meant by this is how the remote collar works on the dog, by being in the background. Brian said, come, Kai, you always say the name of the dog and then come. Either come or here. He said, Kai, come. As soon as he said come, he just hit the remote collar. The dog felt the smallest little, like boom, boom, boom. The dog came to him. He said, sit. Hit the button again. Use the food to lure the dog into a sit. The dog sat, made eye focus. Good, 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 good. Break, fed the dog. Repeat, 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 repeat. Then he called the dog over to place, used the word place, hit the buttons. Whenever Brian used the word
come, sit, or place, he hit the button on the remote. It's on a level 1, all right? You don't have to mention your dog's name. Yep, that's all it was. The remote collar is not doing the training. The training is doing the training. The remote collar right now is sort of in the background. Eventually, the dog will be fully remote collar trained. Why do we do remote collars? We could have done this exercise without the remote collar, but the goal is to have that dog off leash with high levels of distraction outside. But we always start it inside. Teach the child to know what A is and B is and C is and D is, and then you have to teach the child the words, teach the child the sentences, and then you teach the child how to walk, how to write. All right? He would have struggled more, probably not. He might not have struggled more without the remote because food drive in puppies is so high. Think about it. The only way this dog is eating is through work. That's it. So the only way this dog is eating is by working. So it's pretty simple. You get a puppy that's hungry, you can do anything with this dog. And that's it. That's how we introduce the remote collar. So there's no shocking. I think someone mentioned about shock. Shock is, and I understand that. That's fine. I understand a lot of people are like, is it a shock collar? No, it's not a shock collar because shock implies pain and actually death, right? So that's it. I was fortunate to have a 14-week-old puppy here, and I was fortunate that he's a super fan of mine, and he's been waiting to come in. He brought his own remote in, and he was ready to work. He was ready to work. So that dog came in. That dog came in pulling on its leash, not listening, no focus. And then you saw, and literally, you saw what the dog was doing. That's how training works. So imagine this owner is going to do this a minimum of twice a day, probably 50 repetitions each time. Come, sit, eye focus, eye focus, eye focus, eye focus, eye focus. Break. Also, he'll do come, place. Eye focus, eye focus, eye focus, eye focus. That's how you train a dog. Thousands of times of repetitions. It's training. So when I used to do triathlons, you know how many freaking sprints I did? You know how many stairs I used to have to do? You know how many, when I was on that bike, you know how many miles I rode on a bicycle? How much swimming I had to do? You train and train and train, so the competition happens itself. You train your dog, train your dog, train your dog, so things just happen. It's the way it is. It's called training for a reason. We train. We train. So that was it. I was very fortunate. I love how my Periscoper saw that. That was awesome. Awesome. I just did a Periscope on how to accomplish the eye focus. You just saw it live. You just saw it. That was it. Get yourself a hungry dog. Get yourself a hungry dog. That dog will look at you. See, this is the thing. A lot of times people are like, how do you do it? And Yoda, you're a super fan of mine. I'm madly in love with you. But a lot of times people are, they're like, where's the training? You saw the training. It's actually easier than people think. It's easier than people think. So the dog had eye focus. If he didn't have eye focus, he just went, or just make a noise. The dog does eye focus again, and boom, you pay. Break and pay. That's it. That's it. That was it. It's time for me to get my butt home. Get my butt home to my family, okay? That's what I need to do, more family time. No, I mean, just if your dog is barking and whining, tell it to shut up. Pet convincer, leash correction, remote collar correction, shake the kennel, take it out, give it a toe tap if you have to. Bang the kennel. I can't stand whining and barking. Can't stand it. So, am I taking them trick-or-treating? My kids, Linda will take them out of our area. She takes them to another town. And they've got to turn over all the Reese's. They have to turn over all the Reese's peanut butter cups to me, or they have to sleep outside. That's a family rule. It's a family rule. Yep, gotta pay. Reese's, come here. They come here. All right, so that was it. Yeah, Max got a heated doghouse, yep. Snickers for you, that's the gift they gotta pay for you, the Snickers. Hey man, we all got our vices. We all got our vices. Yeah, Max got a heated doghouse and he loves it. A lot of hearts, let's heart me up, heart me up, heart me up. You can also share this. Don't forget, on the repeats, you can swipe and share left to right on an iOS, up and down on an Android. Share it to Facebook, share it to Twitter. Also, what you can do is, there's a little character right here in the corner. Click on that. You can also share on the live, Twitter, Facebook. Also, follow me and make sure you turn your alerts on. Follow me and turn your alerts on. That was really cool. I like that session. That was good. So we did two today. Two Periscopes today. So, that might be it. Exactly. All right. But my kids, did I get your Twitter shots? I've got to look. I haven't looked at my Twitter yet today. Yeah, my kids don't have a peanut allergy. My kids just don't want to sleep outside. So, they give me the Reese's. So, I guess it works. I guess, right? It works for both of us. It works for both of us, right? That's it. Any last questions? That's what's really cool. That guy is a Periscope guy. He's been watching me on Periscope since I started. He couldn't wait to get in here to do all that. So he signed up his dog 3 weeks ago when it was 11 weeks old. But that's about our waiting time. It's about 3 to 4 weeks right now. All right, that's it. This is our training center. Has everybody seen the rubber room? We call this the rubber room. Anybody want to see the training center?
So this is, I'll give everybody a quick tour. Okay, so this is the front. So that's the front door. People come in here. These lights are normally on up there. They look really beautiful. This is where Melinda and Lauren work. So Lauren is my personal assistant. Melinda is my office person. This is like a little waiting area right there. We only allow one dog at a time in here. This is a private facility. And then obviously mop buckets are out because we're doing cleaning right now. We've got a washing machine in here. We've got two bathrooms. One bathroom has a shower. This is behind the blue wall, which has got all of our daycare and our kennels. This is the training area right here. The training area here. This is Melissa, one of my kick-ass employees who loves being on camera. So there's a couple photos I put up of Melissa. Have you guys seen her walking four humongous dogs? How awesome is that? How awesome is that? She's got, what is that, Melissa? Probably about 350 or 400 pounds of dog you've got with you. She walks like a boss. Walks like a boss. So here's a great example. So Melissa is a kennel staff. She's not a trainer, she's kennel staff. But guess what though? She's still training dogs. She's, you know, every aggressive dog that comes in my property, she's got to like at least take it out to go to the bathroom. So here's just some agility equipment. We don't do agility. Here are these climb things, K-L-I-M-B, wheelchair for distractions, some hoops. Here's some of our distraction equipment, confidence building equipment, some platform. Here's some bite work stuff. Here's a bunch of distraction equipment. There's a bite suit right there. If you want to see the right behind that door is the training apartment. If you want to see what that looks like, you can go to the Periscope from yesterday. And I'm actually looking for a groomer right now. I'm looking for a groomer. And this is our custom tub that we built. It's a custom wash tub we built. And this room right here has not been finished yet, but I'm looking for a groomer there's a separate entrance that leads outside. So I'm looking for a groomer to take over this space, and I'll do all the build out. I'll build you your own grooming place. Yep. So I'm looking for somebody that's got an existing grooming business. And then right over here is sort of like a little office area. So we eat there. There's a couch, that's my briefcase. Some supplies, refrigerator, coffee machine. That door that you see, electric cow, yeah, remote cow training, yep. You missed the demo already. We did a 14-week old puppy on a remote cow. So if you're not experienced with remote cowers, we show how we do it. It's all at low level, it's all paired up with food. Okay, cool, well then it's time to get off, right? Like, then get off. All right. Got somebody, that's pretty bad that you've got so much hate in your life. That's too bad. It's too bad. So, oh well, what are you gonna do? Can't make everybody happy, can you? Right? Can't make everybody. All right, so that's that. Yeah, don't worry about it, Don. Don, it doesn't bother me, don't let it bother you. All right? Don't ever let it bother. Nobody's gotta stick up for me. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about that.
People that are just misinformed. Never worry about that. Now, people do that. People do that all the time. Is electric shock necessary? I'm not using electric shock, so there's no electric shock used at all. So what I would suggest you do is you can look up about modern remote collar training. Though I don't think you should be electric shocking your dog at all. We don't. We don't use electric shock at all. So how does it work? Well, I'm about to close out this Periscope. I've got over 1,000 videos on YouTube. I've got how-to videos. There's also lots of great information online. It's low-level stimulation. There's no shocking or zapping of the dog. There's so much free information out there. There are hundreds and hundreds of trainers that use remote collar training to fully off-leash train dogs, but there's no shocking or zapping at all. What you can do is you can watch this replay and you can see how we started training. It's the client's first lessons, okay? Yeah, look it up. But I can assure you, there's no shocking, there's no zapping. The dog came in here on a slip lead, pulling it, that was damaging to the dog. So, yep. Yeah, it's not painful at all. So you buy one from eCower Technologies or Dogtra and watch my how-to videos. Watch my how-to videos. So you can mess up your dog with a lot of stuff, not just remote cowers. So that's why I put out so much free content. Yep. All right, guys. Sarah, take care. All right, I'm madly in love with you guys. Swipe and share, follow me. All right, follow me. That'd be great. It's so funny how people judge, isn't it? So he hates me because I use remote collars on dogs. Like, wow, how do you feel about like wife beaters or animal abusers, right? It's like, wow, sucks to have hate in your life. You know, God, why would you want to have hate in your life? Life's too short. We don't need it. We don't need any hate. We don't need any hate. All we need is more love. More love, more understanding, more education. Raise the bar of animals. 5 million dogs. You know what you should really not like? 5 million dogs a year are killed in the United States. 5 million dogs, right? You might want to channel that anger somewhere else, right? Not here, we're actually saving dogs' lives. But anyway, none of it really bothers me. Whatever. You know, this is the thing. Don't put out free content if you're not ready for people to criticize you. Right? I put myself out there. It's to be expected. It's sort of, you know, it's part of the job. It's part of the job. That's what's going to happen. I do them on Mondays and Wednesdays. Monday and Wednesday at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Monday and Wednesday at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. All right? All right, guys. Madly in love with you. Going to go home. And, oh shit, I gotta go stop at the post office. I gotta go. All right, talk to everybody later.